Yes, sirree. Just got back from a big shopping trip, and I was able to find these little, I think they're called U-nails. I saw them before. I didn't know what they were called. I was researching last night, but U-nails. And, you know, I think, by the way, this will be the beginning. I think this is the beginning of part 11. Same day as, actually, this is part 12, so 11... I have to shorten up my videos, so I just got done transferring that over. So what I'm going to do, like I said, there's 108 stitches, 216 double stitches in a baseball. So you see this is just a foam, and I'm just indenting it. I'm going to count these out. I'm going to stick them in. And the reason I'm sticking them in is because when I spray paint them, they will... sticking up, easy to use. I just had this little foam pad. I did stop and get a cup of coffee at my favorite JJ Bean. Always has there's always people in there. I stopped off and picked up some sushi, a couple of groceries, went and picked up some spray paint, some of these nails. So tack on another $45. Like I say, my wife's gone for 3 weeks and I'm up over $1,000. Keep on spending. I was actually watching back a couple of the videos just to get some, to see the continuity of things and how I'm making out. And I think part 10 I had on a red turtleneck, and I'm back to my favorite blue. This has been my work shirt for this whole season. I just, I kind of put it on in the wintertime, I like having a turtleneck at work because, first of all, it's chilly, it keeps you warm. Secondly, I'm not going to lie to you, I've always liked the style of a turtleneck. In my opinion, they've never gone out of style. Thirdly, there's lots of dust happening, and I know we should be wearing the proper mask, but sometimes in a quick fix, I pull this up, and although it's not perfect, it'll keep a lot of the, bigger chunks of stuff out, sawdust and stuff like that. So that's another reason. Oh, I dropped one. And I wonder if anybody's ever made a wooden baseball and used these as the stitches, the seams before. Or is this a first? That's a good question. Baseball season is in full swing. But up here in Canada, many of us always love April because it's the beginning of the NHL playoffs, and that's a long 2 month tournament to be able to hoist the championship Stanley Cup trophy. And for those of you who are unaware, in order to win it, you have to go through and win 4 best of 7 series. And let me tell you, playoff hockey is very intense, and it requires a lot of things going right in order for a team to come away with that trophy. You gotta have good goaltending. You gotta be lucky without injuries. And many things. It's an amazing thing to watch the emotion after they win it. Speaking of injuries, the other night, the opening night of the playoffs, I think it was Monday night, the goaltender's skate come up and slashed a player off of the Winnipeg Jets in the face, and he required over 70 stitches. And that happened in the first period, and believe it or not, the player came back and played in the rest of the game. So hockey culture is a little like that. Injuries, players usually play through some major injuries. It's a pretty tough sport. Okay, a few more to put in. Then I'm gonna run some spray paint over these. Usually when I'm doing a sculpture, the spray paint, you know, that's also takes a lot of to do that good. You never want anything running, and it's a real delicate procedure to do that properly too. So it's just it's a little bit at a time. So I'll put on like the first kind of coat, let it dry, and then I'll put on a couple of more coats. I like having the paint thick on my sculptures. It just gives it a little bit more robust, a little bit more longevity if something starts to get beat up or something like that. And so what did I go with? I went with a color that they refer to as, if you want the French, it's Rouge Colonial Luster. But it's a colonial red. It's more like maroony. And I didn't want to go with like that bright apple red, I think they called it. And I just thought that this would look better next to a nice stain of wood and kind of a little bit more of a classic look. So I'm gonna get this ready to go. This one. Well, okay, what do I got going on here? I got, if you can see those little, you could probably see my little stitches there. So I got them all marked out. Like, I didn't take any measurements. I just basically guessed a halfway mark of what the stitches were, and then I just tried to do my best to put them all in. So I'm going to put them all in. Baseball, like I said, 108 stitches, 216 double stitches, they call it. And I think I have a little bit of a system here to do that. It's going to be a bit of a challenge because I'm going to pre-drill some holes, put those in. I'm still going to have to bang them in with a hammer so the top of the paint's going to come off. Then after they're all in, I'm assuming I'm going to have to go around with a paintbrush and touch them up. So it's going to take a lot of time. But that is what I'm going to do. Hello! How are you?
We're in a bit of a rush.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna go around and do some pre-drilling some holes. I had switched over to Dwight Yoakam. So I'm almost done drilling these, pre-drilling my first series of holes. Okay, now, I also put another coat of paint on those, didn't get that on the camera. Well, I'm gonna sand that. Yeah, I think I'm going to sand that. There's still lots of fiddling around here to do, so I'll get it done little bit by little bit.